So by default in Blender, you have basic key maps or key bindings attached to basic functions. So when I press tab, I go into edit mode and out of edit mode. If I press Z, I toggle wireframe. Let me just turn on my screencast keys. There we go. But we can work a bit faster by enabling the Pi menu add-ons. So if you go to user preferences add-ons and you type Pi in the search field, you will see two Pi menu options. So you should enable both. I already have one enabled, but I need to enable the individual hotkeys for it. So I'll do that by clicking the I menu, and I'll enable the other one. So you see these are all enabled, and then I click the I and I enable the individual ones. So now if I press Z, I have a bunch of other options to select from, and you can work really fast this way. Same with pressing A to select and deselect. But I prefer using another version of the Pi menus from someone called Cédric Lipelier, or his nickname is Petit Oiseau. And so if I go to his GitHub page, you can see the link here. And then he has a bunch of add-ons, but we're looking specifically for the Pi menus. So I click on Pi menus, and then on raw I right-click and save link as. And then I change the extension to PY for Python. And then I save it in my add-ons folder. And then if I go to user preferences again and I refresh, I should see, I need to change the extension. Somehow it's still set txt. So I refresh a few times, it shows up, I enable it. And then you see the key maps here. And this is basically just a little bit more of an advanced Pi menu with a few more options. So if I press, a tab for component mode, and then I can select something, press X, and to dissolve and delete individual components, stuff like that. So it's a little bit more advanced, and I prefer this one over the default. And then the same creator also has another add-on called RMB Pi Menu version 2 on his Gumroad. You can see the link here, and I recommend getting that one as well. I already downloaded it and I just copied it to my folder. And so if I go back to preferences, add-ons, and type WAZ, his add-on should pop up after refreshing a few times. There we go. So I'll enable that. And now if you right click, so he has, you see the bunch of information about the add-on with all the options. I recommend checking that out. And also there's a bunch of additional add-ons you may, that it works in conjunction with. So you'll have to get those as well, like the Otter Mirror, as you can see here. It's noticing that it's missing, so you might want to install the additional add-ons listed. So that's it for the Pi menus.